There is a fire in my heart to tell the world just who you are in everything I do, in everything I say. I will never be ashamed, 'cause I just wanna let go. Jesus, you have saved me, so I will never be ashamed. I will sing from the rooftops with all that I have. I'm gonna lift up both of my hands. I'm gonna make it loud. Gonna sing and shout from the rooftops. Oh, you are my God. Oh, you are my God. Oh. So with this fire in my heart, I'll tell the world just who you are, and everything I do, and everything I say. I will never be afraid, be afraid. From the rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands. I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout from the rooftop. Oh, never stop loving us, you'll never stop. No, you'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop. No, you'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop. No, you'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop. No. With all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands. I'm gonna make it loud. Gonna sing and shout from the rooftops. Oh, you are my God. 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 You are my. You are my God. You are my.
What is up, everyone? Welcome to One and All Kids.
We are starting our next week of Ready, Set, Move, where we're following Jesus as best as we can.
Looking at the Bible gives us the best possible way to follow Jesus, and memorizing verses can help us do that even better.
Our memory verse is from Ephesians 2:8, which says, "For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith, and it is not from yourselves, it is the gift of God."
That verse is amazing. It reminds us that we can always rely on God's grace being bigger than our works.
Last week, we heard about Paul and Silas being thrown in prison. This week, we're hearing about Paul's shipwreck. Let's go.
Welcome back for another game.
It's still summer.
Still summer. I believe right now I am still the winner.
Just by one.
Still the winner because that sneak was ridiculous, but nobody won. Only you guys won because you got to see us touch interesting things. But I'm still 1 point ahead, I believe, from Josh. So he could really quickly turn this around, but let's see what happens. We are missing our lovely game table today. So Tyler, where's the table?
The table is gone because you're gonna need all the space you can get. We're gonna be playing some charades. So in front of you, which I don't think the kids can see, is a bowl. In that bowl are strips of paper with things on it that you have to act out. However, I don't know what they are because I am the one that is going to be guessing what you're acting out. However, you each only have a minute and a half to get me to guess as many slips of paper as you can. Nice. Whoever gets me to guess the most wins.
All right.
Well, are you good at charades?
I honestly have not played a lot of games of charades, but I'm much better with my words
gonna
so,
be very interesting.
We'll see.
Yeah, I the last time I played was in front of a campfire.
Yeah, I think it's hard to play charades with just one person guessing. So we
Tyler, are you good
see.
At guessing?
That's a cool question.
We're about to find out, but I want to know if the kids are going to be better at guessing than I am, because they can guess right along with me as you guys act out whatever is on those slips of
paper. So we can use...
All right, everybody. Josh, you're going to head this one up. You're going to go first. You're going to kick us off.
Because I'm losing, right?
No, I just picked you.
Okay.
All right, your time starts now. Driving a car. A garbage truck.
Yeah!
Frozen. Drums. Bongo drum.
Do you even know what this is?
Okay.
Yeah, just get another one. Yeah.
Okay.
Eating spoon, fork, knife, chew. Eating food. You're scooping a spoon? Chip, chips and dip, chips and salsa. Tortilla chip. Titanic. Cross, Jesus. Nice. Swimming. Swimming race. Michael Phelps. Lifeguard. 10 seconds. Asleep. Fell asleep. Sleeping Beauty. Bathtub. Sleeping hammock. That's it.
Is it? Okay, do we want to count that? It's the answer is sleeping in a hammock. And we got sleeping in a hammock.
Sleeping hammock. Do we want to include if you left out
Tyler's
the words
the judge.
In a... said sleeping hammock.
For my own, I was guessing sleeping and I was separately guessing hammock. So we're going to say that's a no.
Okay.
So close. Jesus, I should have done your resurrection, but
Jesus.
I did you on the cross.
Yeah. We got tortilla chips. We got a lifeguard and we got a garbage truck.
Whew. All right, four.
That
four
was hard. 9 seconds.
That was pretty hard. All right, okay. Julianne, your time is going to start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Skiing.
Yep. Oh, no.
Rain, river, fall, river, waterfall, cannonball, jumping down a waterfall.
This is a really hard.
Going down a waterfall in a barrel.
Yes. Look at
that. That's a thing.
That was impressive. Yeah.
Dancing, twirling. Ice skating? Music box? Oh, ballerina? Ballet? Dancing? For some reason, I know that song, but it's like not clicking right now.
How much time is left?
Marching band?
How else do you do this?
Music conductor? Roller coaster? 5. Princess
that
Leia?
That was a hard one.
Oh, we're done.
Disneyland.
Oh, I should have known that.
It's a small world.
That's what it is. I could not.
Wait, how many did she get?
Think of it.
How many did she get? So you didn't get Disneyland, so that's 3. Which means I get a W.
I'm sorry, Julianne, but congratulations, Josh.
tied it back up, baby.
Tied up. Okay, I can come back from this.
We are tied in our summer game series. Now it's time to head on into service.
I hope you were entertained. I hope you were too. Disneyland, Tyler.
I know. I haven't gone in a long time. It's sad, but we're excited for you to get into service. We will see you next week for some more games. Bye, guys.
Hey everybody, my name is Pastor Julianne, and we are in our Ready, Set, Move series, learning about following Jesus. Last week, we heard about Paul and Silas being joyful even when they were in prison. This week, we're learning about Paul being shipwrecked. Our bottom line this week is when bad things happen, God is with you. How many of you have been on a road trip before? You and your family pack up the car, grab your suitcases for the trip, pack the good snacks, and get on the road. Road trips can be super fun, but this road trip we're learning about today is a rough one. It is so rough that it doesn't even happen on a road. We have been learning about Paul and his journeys to share Jesus with the world around him. He travels to a lot of places to make friends and share with them about who Jesus is and what he did for them. This made some people upset, and Paul was beaten, imprisoned, mocked, and chased out of town at different points in his journeys. To spare Paul's life, he was put in prison, and while he was there, he pleaded his case. Since Paul was a Roman citizen, he was going to have his case heard by the most powerful ruler in the world at the time, Caesar. So he was shipped off to Rome, and that's where our story goes crazy. Acts 27:13-20 says this. When a gentle south wind began to blow, they saw their opportunity, so they weighed anchor and sailed along the shore of Crete. Before very long, a wind of hurricane force called the Northeaster swept down from the island. The ship was caught by the storm and could not head into the wind, so we gave way to it and were driven along. As we passed to the lee of a small island called Cauda, we were hardly able to make the lifeboat secure, so the men hoisted it aboard. Then they passed ropes under the ship itself to hold it together because they were afraid they would run aground on the sandbars of Cyprus. They lowered the sea anchor and let the ship be driven along. We took such a violent battering from the storm that the next day they began to throw cargo overboard. On the third day, they threw the ship's tackle overboard with their own hands. When neither sun nor stars appeared for many days and the storm continued raging, we finally gave up all hope of being saved. On their way to Rome, the ship gets absolutely wrecked by a storm, and several people, prisoners and guards, are afraid for their lives. But Paul tells them that God will spare their lives and that they will make it to Rome. He trusts God and convinces the others to trust him. Eventually, their boat is broken on an island and they are stranded there. Many guards wanted to kill the prisoners, but Paul tells them not to, and everyone arrives safely on the island of Malta. Paul was able to pray for and perform miracles in Jesus' name for the people who lived on the island. And after 3 months, they were finally able to set sail for Rome once again. After they made it, the leader of the ship's guards, Julius, was so thankful for Paul and the journey that he was allowed to have visitors in Rome, even though Paul was under guard. Because of this, Paul was able to share Jesus with the Roman people and all the visitors that he had. Acts 28:30-31 says this. For 2 whole years, Paul stayed there in his own rented house and welcomed all who came to see him. He proclaimed the kingdom of God and taught about the Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance. Paul had some really, really bad things happen on this journey, but he understood that God was with him through it all. I have a friend to share a little bit more about this, so let's hear from them.
Hi, I'm Craig, and I'm excited to share with you today. When I was growing up, my favorite sport to play was soccer. It's so fast-paced, fun to be on a team, and you get lots of snacks. Raise your hand if you like soccer. Yeah? Okay. Every year, I had always played rec soccer, which is the normal level team, and I enjoyed that a lot. But one year, I had the chance to try out for the select team. The select team was some of the best players from our area. I was so excited about the possibility of being a part of that team. So my friends and I tried out together. I thought it went well, but then the results came back. All of my friends had made the team except me. I was crushed. I felt so rejected and embarrassed. How could I be the only one that didn't belong on the team? Even though I didn't realize it at the time, God was with me, and He was working out a plan that was for my good, and He was going to teach me a few things in the process. My dad talked to the trainer for the team, and he said that I seemed like a great player, they just didn't have enough spots on the team for me. He said I could come practice with the team. So now, my dad was telling me that I should go practice with the team even though I hadn't made it? I felt so rejected and embarrassed and didn't want to practice with all my friends that had actually made the team. But my dad insisted, so I went and practiced with them. I felt awkward being there, but I stuck with it. And then after a few weeks, something crazy happened. Eventually, a spot opened up and I was able to be on the team. Through that hard time, God was with me. In that situation, He taught me to never give up, to keep persevering, and to not worry so much about what other people think of me. God loves us so much, and because we are His children, we have so much value and worth. No matter what others think or say about us, we are loved. Whether we make the select soccer team or not, God says that we are special and valuable. I hope that you remember that today too. Whatever happens, God will be with you.
When bad things happen, God is with you. You might think just because Paul was doing God's work, because Paul was going where God was sending him, that things would be smooth sailing. Complete cakewalk. Nope, not even close. Even though God was directing Paul's steps, he still went through some really hard times. Just because you're walking out your faith, obeying what God is telling you to do, doesn't mean that things are always going to be easy. I'm guessing some of you have gone through or are going through some pretty difficult stuff. And there's no getting around it, but sometimes life is just plain hard. And at the same time, it might make little to no sense at all. But when we're able to see these moments with a new perspective, believing that Jesus is with us and that He will never leave us, it gives us hope to see our way through our problems. It doesn't always mean that it's going to be easy. It doesn't mean that it won't hurt, but it does mean that when we're in the middle of the storm, battered on every side, we won't be alone. Jesus is with us. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for Paul's story, that it can inspire us to hold on to hope, hold on to you, and know that you are with us even in the roughest storms of our life. God, I know there's kids out there listening to this right now that are going through such hard times, and maybe they've talked about it with someone and maybe they haven't, but God, I pray that they would talk to you about it. I pray that they would trust you, that you are with them and you are going to comfort them and you are going to help them make it through no matter how bad their situation is. God, that you see them, you see what they're feeling, and you care about them. You care so much that you sent your son to die for them. God, we love you so much, and we're so thankful for everything that you've done. Help us to trust you and remember that you're with us no matter what. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Paul has some pretty serious hardships.
Yes, he has. But God always provides a way for Paul to share the gospel with the people that are around him.
I might think I have the best plans, but I am so thankful that God has the best plan ever, and that His plans are way better than mine. That's why I have faith in what He does.
One way that we can show God and others how thankful we are is by giving our offering.
When we give our offering money, we're telling God that we understand that He's the one who gives all of the things in our lives. When we give our money, we are being obedient to God, but we're also worshiping Him for who He is and what He's done for us.
You can talk to your parents and leaders about giving your offering today.
Now it's time to grow together. This can look like singing and dancing. This can look like hanging out with your community group and your leaders, or it can look like something else. But I'm glad that we all get to do it together. Let's go.
Freedom is calling. You are singing over me. Heaven is open. Moments like these invite me. I was breathing.
Love growing closer to Jesus with you, and I can't wait to do it again next week.
So exciting. Don't forget to invite some friends as we learn more about living our lives with faith in Jesus. Until then, we want to send you out into the week with one hope,
one life
in Christ.
Bye, friends.
See you later.